dSPACE is a trusted technology leader enabling pioneers for electromobility and autonomous driving to make the life safer, cleaner, and easier. We are providing cutting-edge tools and solutions for developments in the core topics, autonomous driving and electromobility. Today, I would like to briefly introduce you to our solutions for developing control development for electric drives. So, what does it mean, control development of electric drives? There are some points that should be considered. You need, for convenient access, a quick iteration process and, of course, access to all the parameters. You need support of the latest motor concepts, for example, by providing the right I/O software environment. And a very important topic is the excellent real-time performance for real powerful calculation algorithms running at highest speed for example, the newest semiconductors. A scalable in-vehicle and laboratory system is also very useful because it allows you to have got a system usable in the vehicle or in the laboratory. So let me show what we have here today. This is an electric drive like a permanent magnet synchron machine with some sensors connected to it. Of course, you need a power electronic like a B6 bridge that needs some PWM signals. Those PWM signals are provided by the dSPACE real-time system, here based on the Scalexio. We have a processor board and one I/O board providing all the signals you need. Analog inputs for current reading and reading and voltage measurement, position sensor reading, as well as signals for controlling the gates from the IGBTs, transistors, or whatever you will use. But as I mentioned, not only for the laboratory, we also have the micro auto box in the newest version. It's the micro auto box 3. You know these connectors? Yes, they are the same as you know already from the micro auto box 2. So you can directly use the same cabling environment and just connect the new micro auto box to get more calculation power and, of course, the new I/O features and the convenience of the configuration. So let's coming back to the demo. With this slide, I shortly would like to show you the workflow. So typically, you will start in MATLAB Simulink by modeling some blocks here for the calculation. After you have done, for example, some offline simulation, you would like to add also our hardware. And then you need I/O access. The I/O access is provided by Configuration Desk. I will show you in a few seconds. When you have connected the model port blocks to your algorithm, then you can download the code that is generated on the real-time system, connect it to the system as it is shown here, power electronics and the drive, and then you get in contact for the experimentation phase. There we offer Control Desk. And so this is a whole circle for doing the prototyping because a new design iteration for some changed requirements can easily be done by changing the algorithm or adding some new I/O functions. So let's have a look to the real system. This is MATLAB. And MATLAB, of course, offers Simulink, and I show you the Simulink functionality that we use for this demonstration. Here, we have got a triggered subsystem. The triggering is done by an interrupt providing block that is definitely defined in Configuration Desk. the control loop consists of the three points, the input, the control, and the output. Input, of course, will contain dSPACE blocks, like here for the AD measurement, we have got the model port blocks connected with some analog inputs, as well as for incremental encoder, for example, we find the right model port block here. And the same is valid for the output. So for the output, there also we will find a model port block connected to the PWM signals generated by the system. And in the middle, there's a controller part. And this is your topic. Your topic where you are the expert, so please do not have too much look to it. We have got a cascaded control loop here. We tried to set up a speed controller followed by a current controller. We applied the field-oriented control approach by doing some transformation, but I'm sure you are the experts and you probably can do it much more better than we did it here. But at least it's good for the demonstration. So when we have done the configuration of the mathematics here and we have to connect it with the real I/O systems, and this is done in Configuration Desk. So let's switch to Configuration Desk. Configuration Desk provides you a library with all the I/O functionalities that you have to use, that you are looking for. For example, we have got analog inputs, we have digital outputs, and also the pulse pattern generation, like the multi-channel PWM signals. We have got different extended signal encoder capturing, as you can see here. And this is available for hardware like this Calexio system, but as you can see here, it's also available for the micro auto box based on Configuration Desk now. So getting a better feeling how the interaction works with MATLAB, Simulink, and Configuration Desk, I just would like to show you by an example. Maybe we add a new PWM signal to our model. Then we just take it, drag and drop it to this part. Then we see, oh, there are some conflicts. We have to define some settings. Definitely, we have to tell the system what is the channel, what is the board that is used, and stuff like this. So this can be done manually, but hopefully this is also possible by connecting it automatically with our assistant tools. Now it is perfectly configured and can be integrated in our Simulink structure now. This is done by having a look to the model as it is shown here. And we have got, for example, the control load machine. And here somewhere is the controller. And there should also be a block for the input and hopefully also for the output. Oh yes, there it is. So I directly place it to the output. Then I say propagate it to Simulink, switch back to Simulink, have a look to the output block, and luckily there it is. So if you get confused by having two blocks here, there's also a way to go back. You just click here and then it is highlighted the block that is already defined here. So it's so easy and comfortable using the functions and propagate them, connect them with your Simulink model. Now we could do the code generation because this is a live demonstration. I better don't do it now, but I've already prepared something for you. So let's switch to Control Desk. As you see, we followed the way that we now connected and now can generate code and work with Control Desk. So Control Desk is the dSPACE tool for getting in contact with the real running algorithms. You get a handle on the application that is running there, and then have got access to all the parameters and the variables that are measured and you want to change. So let's do it and let's see what happens. The motor is not running. Let's see whether we can start it. I switch to speed control, and we have got a speed set of 750 rotations per minute, and the control achieves it quite well, so it's quite stable speed, and this is the change from minus to plus 750. As you can see here, I change back to minus 750 rotations per minute, and now the left. Now you see that the curve changes when I set the new triggering. The triggering is done when the speed changes from a negative or left turning to a right turning. And we also could change the speed of the control. Now we run with 50 microseconds as the interrupt basis. So each 50 microsecond, a new interrupt is given on the system, because our the frequency of the PWM is 50 kilohertz, is 20 kilohertz. We could increase the speed, for example, by changing the frequency to 20 kilohertz. Then see what happens now. Okay, we can see the new triggering. I change the time scale here. And now the signal looks quite the same. Also, we have a lot of more capturings done for this new measurement. So you can see it's quite easy to have got this change, to work with it, also to change some parameters. For example, we could change the control KI parameter for the speed control, and then you can see here a different kind of behavior. So this brings me to the end of my 2 days presentation. I would like a little bit too fast to summarize it, that dSPACE offers a big variety of products for laboratory and in-vehicle systems, with also some power electronics and the tooling to have got convenient access to it. Thank you very much. See you next time. Bye bye.
dSPACE, your partner in simulation and validation.